Shalom, friends. Dr. Victoria Sarvati here with Candid Treasures. Today, we're going to be talking about the soul. And what is the soul? And where does it go when we die? You know, man is made up of three components: body, soul, and spirit. When God made man, he stooped down to the earth and he formed man, creating man from the elements of the earth. And when we die, our body breaks down, decomposes, and becomes dust again, as it were before it was ever formed. But our spirit, it belongs to God. When a baby's born and takes its first breath, there is life force, there's life spirit going into that child. This is when God puts his breath into us. And all of our lives, we breathe his name. Think about it. His name is a Yud He Vav He. In fact, whenever God changed Abram's name to Abraham, he put his breath into him. So every time we breathe, we're saying a part or a component of God's name, the breath. In fact, the word, the letter He means breath. So God's breath is in us, keeping us alive. And our soul is another part of us that we need to train. We need to tame it. We need to bring it into submission. What is our soul? Your soul is a sum total of your reasoning. It's of your emotions. It's your experiences. It's your memory. It's your thoughts. It is all that you think about all day long. It's what you're experimenting and observations have been, and you have created opinions. It's your very essence of who you think you are, your philosophy, your viewpoint, your worldview. It's how you think. All of that is your soul. When I died in 1978, my body literally stopped. The heart wasn't beating, breath was not there, but I was still alive. I remember coming out of my body. I remember looking down at my body. So what was that entity that I called me? It was my soul. And I was looking at the body and I was thinking, I was reasoning with an angel. I was talking, communicating. I had my emotions, I had my memories. My soul was still intact. It just was no longer into the body. You know, it says in Psalms 139:13 that God created us, our innermost being, and he knitted it together in our mother's womb. What is this innermost being but the soul? And the soul, whenever we become born again, is knitted together to our spirit man. The spirit man belongs to God. When we die, the spirit returns to him. That's what the word says. And it also says the spirit does not sin. So it's not your spirit that is sinning whenever you fall short of God's holy word. In fact, it's the spirit that's in you. It's the deep voice. It's the deep calling to you that says, I really don't like being in this place. I really don't like what I just did. It's like a conscience, a barometer that calls us. In fact, it brings us to God if we'll listen to that still small voice of the spirit. And when we're born again, what happens? The soulish part of you is knitted together with the spirit man, so that when your body finally does die, your soul is united with your spirit and goes on to be with God, because that's where the spirit belongs. If you do not give your life over to him, if you choose to make idols out of everything, it could be pleasure, it could be just making yourself happy and ignoring God and doing your own thing, or it could give yourself over to Satan because he's promised, you know, great power and wealth or whatever, or idols. Idols can be so many different things in our life that takes us away from God. If it's those things, then we've disconnected from our spirit man. And when we die, our soul is not connected any longer to the spirit that belongs to God. It's connected to all these other things that are opposing God and opposing his word. And so your soul goes into the darker realms for eternity, separated from God. So what I suggest to you today is to take a good look at yourself and see the things that are within you that are not lining up with God. Ask him to knit together your soul, every part of your mind, emotions, your thoughts. Bring every thought into captivity. Give all of that over to the Lord. Say, God, knit this to my spirit man so that I can bring the soul under control. and submit to what you have called me to be. So I pray that you take this week and walk in the Spirit. Allow God to make this knitting together in so many different facets of your life so that you will be with him when the time comes to lay the body down. You have a great day. Shalom.